Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchaudhary, Development Lead for the IBM AppConnect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate some enhancements we have made for developers who are creating integration solutions using AppConnect Enterprise. The Integration Explorer view in the toolkit now has an option for creating an independent integration server. The wizard allows you to specify a name for the integration server and configure some ports for commonly used functions. The default name is test_server. If you wish, you may allow the toolkit to find ports that are currently free. This allows you to quickly deploy and test your message flows using a local integration server. The REST administration port must be configured so that REST requests can be sent to the integration server over HTTP. This port is also used for the web UI. The port for HTTP-based flows is used after the flow has been deployed. The toolkit will only select a port that is currently free at the time when the integration server is started. If a port is in use at the time when the flow is deployed, then the flow will not start. The JVM debug port is used for debugging message flows. If you do not want to enable the JVM debug port, you can specify 0. After clicking on Finish, a work directory is created in the workspace. The server is started and a link is provided to open the console.log file, which contains the standard out from the integration server. The console.log is contained in the work directory top-level folder. The port values are written to a server.conf.yaml file in the overrides subfolder under the work directory. We recommend that any other configuration that is needed is done to the server.conf.yaml file in the overrides subfolder for clarity. Another new enhancement for developers is an improved dialog window which shows deployment messages more clearly. On deploying a bar file, you can see what resources have been deployed. You can also clearly see if there are any problems. For example, if I deploy the same flow but with a Use HTTPS checkbox selected, an error occurs on deploy, indicating that the flow cannot start as no key store has been configured. If you click on the copy button, all deploy messages are copied to a clipboard, which you can paste into a text editor. This is useful if you need to share the messages with a colleague or your system administrator. Similarly, the dialog is shown if an error occurs when starting a resource. The dialog contains detailed text for each BIP error message. You can also copy the messages to a clipboard and paste into a text editor. You can enable service trace or user trace for the integration server if you need to check areas of your integration solution. For example, if I enable user trace and then put a message through the flow, and stop user trace afterwards, I can now check the user trace that was generated. The user trace is located in config/common/log under the work directory. In this example, I can see the lines of eSQL that were executed in the compute node of my message flow. In addition to starting and stopping trace, you can also start and stop monitoring and statistics for an integration server. In my previous video, I explained how to use the new MQSI Vault and MQSI Credentials commands to store and encrypt credentials that are used to access resources from your message flows. While developing your applications, you may want to quickly test aspects of your message flow without wanting to configure a vault and encrypt credentials. For this reason, you may now set your credentials in the server.conf.yaml file. You just need to specify the credential type and credential name under a server credentials section in the server.conf.yaml. In this example, I'm setting the username and password to access a DB2 database over JDBC. I'm referencing the credential name from within a JDBC provider's policy. After changing the server.conf.yaml, the integration server must be stopped and started for the configuration changes to be picked up. After setting the credentials in server.conf.yaml and restarting the integration server, I am deploying the policy project containing the JDBC provider's policy, which references the credential demo_ID. I am using the flow exerciser to put a test message through the message flow. The integration server can now use the credentials when processing messages in a message flow. You can start multiple integration servers from the toolkit. Each integration server must have a unique name and a matching work directory in the workspace. I have created another local integration server called test_server2. I'm deploying an application to it. The next available port has been configured for HTTP-based message flows. In this example, port 7801 has automatically been configured for the HTTP port. If an integration server is stopped and the connection is removed, the work directory is not removed. You can create an integration server which is using an existing work directory in the workspace if it is not in use. A warning message is shown to indicate that the configuration in the existing work directory will be used. The toolkit does not do full process management for the locally started integration server. If a toolkit is closed, the locally started integration server is stopped. However, if a toolkit closes unexpectedly, then the integration server may not be stopped. You must take care to stop the integration server using OS process management tools if this happens. In addition, an integration server is not automatically started when the toolkit is started. It must be manually started. The stop and start menu options for an integration server are only available if it was started from the toolkit. I am creating a connection to an integration server which is running on a remote machine called sachin.hersey.ibm.com using port 7600. If it was started remotely and a connection was made to it from the toolkit, there is no option to start or stop that integration server. In this video, I've shown that you can now create an independent integration server from the toolkit so that you can quickly test your flows without needing to open a command console and use a number of commands. A new dialog is shown when deploying a bar file or starting a deployed resource. Options on the integration server allow you to enable or disable trace, monitoring, and statistics. You can set credentials in the server.conf.yaml so that you can quickly test your message flows which are interacting with external resources. These enhancements make it an improved experience for developers using AppConnect Enterprise to develop integration solutions.